Yeah, coming to the first competitive advantage of business analytics or business intelligence, interchangeable word, finding more sales opportunities, decreasing the number of customers you lose, and create competitive advantage in the business. Especially, we can focus on frequent customers, frequently who are all visiting our business. Websites or business promotions, or who are all losing, what is the cause for their withdrawal, how I can retain, how I can attract back. So either way you can focus or both. So next, coming to this POCA software, this is one of the software, US-based software. POCA software looks for these are all the kind of business intelligence or BA reports, generating BA reports, all the forms of visualization and all the forms of BA reports it is generating. So if you wish, you can just explore. There are not only that, we ourselves can develop our own package for our own business. Measure over understock when create competitive advantage. Understock we need to fill. That is what supply chain management you guys mentioned. So we need to refill the basket inventory so that your sale promotion, how long you can say out of stock, out of stock. So that you need to do. Dead stock elimination, how you can avoid that. Then gain a clear view of profitability. So that is what another. Then decrease time IT is tied up with reporting request. This is what the issue I said. If you rely on human, he will go understand a different perspective, then he'll bring you the report in different perspective. Then again the cycle should repeat. Again you need to instruct well which is the kind of a report you are expecting. Then that business lead, I mean to say. Then the next report generator need to go. This all need to be avoided with automatic report generation. So that is another advantage. Next, speed and accuracy of reporting. Automation only can do speed and accuracy. Trends in your business pattern. So these are all the next. What is the trending analysis? That's what we discussed. Discover new ways to cut cost. Cost cutting is another method. Employee cost cutting, that is also better. Or automation, certain area we may need to automate, only then cost cutting is possible. So resource optimization, that is called. The moment you call cost cutting, the technical terminology would become resource optimization. So cost cutting you can discuss. Personalized customer service, Amazon, Netflix, Uber, so many. Uber also does personalized customer service. So chatbot, nowadays it increases lot of customer satisfaction, chatbot. The moment you get into Edureka website, Simply Learn website, or any kind of website, immediately chatting conversation will happen. Chatbot, immediately they will attract. Immediately they will be clarifying your queries. Earlier, one day, how many calls a customer call service provider can patiently can talk, patiently can articulate. At one point, a human tend to dilute. They may not answer appropriately to the customer. So that customer satisfaction is the primary role for customer bo the business boosting. The moment I feel attracted with any of the vendor, I'll be going and purchasing. It's all mere our choice. So that customer satisfaction is also a primary role. And this chatbots gives the notification based on the conversation or based on the interest proposed by the viewers. So lot of places chatbot right now incorporated, even ticket booking. And it is Siri is one of the example for chatbot. And Alexa, Google Talk, Alexa is one of the example for chatbot. So it's taking the voice speech to text, then again it gives back speech. So this all the kind of innovation or what is it taking place with the support of NLP. Here not a conventional or structured data will be helping. Merely you need to go for deep learning or NLP, but this is also one of the use case you can put forth for the data analytics. Then beyond that, I wanted to discuss one of the use case for you. So the use case is Uber use case or Ola. Uber and Ola both goes like this. These are all the, what to say, services does based on very first carpooling. carpooling itself, business analytics starts. See, if you look at lakhs together cars available with either Uber or Ola. So there are people booking for the business association or business promotion minimum 0.5 lakhs, especially if we consider Hyderabad city, 0.5 lakhs car available. Minimum, I'm saying, I'm not sure about exactly. Attached with either Uber or Ola. Then car pooling, it starts. How to pool the car in each and every pin location? There itself, it starts the data analytics. How they will be pooling out monumental data or historical data they will take. From the historical data, past 3 weeks analysis, because it's all seasonal. So 3 weeks analysis, past 3 months analysis, and a year, 1 year analysis, all together in any combination they will be doing. They will be having monitoring, they will be doing everything. So based on this, every pin location, imagine JNTU nearby, it varies. Ola and Uber services available for 24 hours. So how many cars need to be placed in that pin location? Between 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. Between 12 a.m. to 1 a.m. 1 p.m. to 2 p.m. Every 24 hours bring the slot. Especially evening hours, 4 to 5. So many colleges located near, in and around JNTU. Our own sister concern BVR at Hyderabad is also available. So pulling out of Uber and Ola, so how many cars need to be placed between 4 o'clock to 5 o'clock, 5 o'clock to 6 o'clock. So these are all those pinpoint it gathers. So based on that historical or monumental data analysis, it decides how many cars need to be channelized. It is not static also. There are cars flowing in towards JNTU. There are cars flowing out from the JNTU. That all need to be considered. So it's kind of dynamic streaming data analytics. It is not a statistics data analytics, what we are doing traditionally in our academics. That all we need to have data warehousing setup. Data literally need to be streamed. So anyway, analytics, it's a kind of analytics. So in which you are doing streaming analytics. Data streaming analytics, you are aiming for these kind of data. Without this, it is not possible to pool your car. So this is the first scenario. You imagine whatever the way you want. Right now, this is the first case I'm telling for data analytics. In what perspective they are using, how they are using. So once if you are understanding this, we need to move on to the next. Within this car analytics itself, we need to move on to the next scenario. Yes, coming to the second point, what would become your second point? Yes, imagine car is pooled. Then next, what is the case? You need to show nearby car. That is fine. Nearby car, after that, geomap analytics. Then until it identifies, where the passenger is standing. It needs to reach that location. For that, geomap analytics comes. That geomap analytics, the moment it comes, shortest path. It computes shortest path immediately. The moment shortest path is happening, this is all geomap processing. Simply we can say map analytics, map processing. What is the prime purpose of doing here? Yeah.
Ma'am, is it geomap?
Yeah. Google map. Geomap, okay. Generally it is called geomap.
Okay.
Geographical map, no? What you will call then geographical map? It is geomap or okay. Google map. Then it is a map processing. Finally, ultimately I said, see, watch the point carefully. So it's a map processing. What it is doing? It is analyzing traffic free path. And also it is going to do shortest path. Again, computation. So this is also your data. This is unstructured data. But it is a data analysis is involved. Without that, you can't succeed. So once traffic analysis and the shortest path it is doing, then what else? Based on this only, the car reaches you. Car reaches the customer. So again, during this pooling, after pooling, the moment the customer places the or searches the search for the car, it needs to gather the data information, streaming data. It offers a lot of provisions. mini car, macro and prime, and it gives pooling. Nowadays auto also available. So these are all those things, pooling for sharing. So these are all the available options. So it needs to pull the data. What are all the mini caps available, macro cap, prime cap, pooling caps, what are all available. So it needs to capture the data. Again, this is also analytics. So based on this, with the closer proximity to the passenger and the driver, closer proximity it considers. Then based on that, it gives the contact details. Either a passenger can contact, the driver will be contacted. Somehow the contact is established. Those who have taken ride in Uber and Ola only can understand. Others cannot understand. Please listen to the concept. So it goes with contacting passenger and driver. So contact passenger and driver is established. The moment you come, next topic is OTP generation. How OTP can generate? So this also need to be gathered. Anything goes wrong right from the OTP, they need to trace out. That data need to be accumulated. That need to be analyzed later on. It is a unique ID. OTP is a kind of unique ID for that transaction, for that ride. So you need to have that OTP. Then the moment the OTP is given, next only this all starts. Shortest path, traffic analysis. So then the the ride starts. The moment ride starts, signal tracking is happening. What is the trigger? Signal tracking? Signal is tracked between the driver and the customer. So how the signal, which path it is going, both of the, and another scenario, when you are traveling, either one of your mobile need to be switched off because of avoiding all the victims or all other mischievous activities. So it is minimum expected response from both customer and the driver is either one should be kept it on. Both are going off, then alert, analyzed. If the customer mobile is switched off, fine. If the driver mobile is switched off, fine. Both of their mobile is switched off. Lot of cases victimized. So that this analytics they are going on. They are tracking both of their status of their mobile. So lot of cases have come. Kidnap cases, misbehavior, malpractice cases have come in the past history. So in order to avoid that, again they are moving on towards these all. Signal tracking. Once the signal tracking is done, then riding goes on. The next drop. The moment to drop, customer drop or passenger drop is carried out. What else? Then rating, review. Rating is a prime role for appreciation and promotions or giving more offer to that particular driver. So how they give offer? Although Uber is available nearby so many, why one particular Uber car is given higher priority by the Uber business head or business model based on the customer rating? So how much that rating goes for that particular fellow? So that much rating also a kind of perks. That perks could be anything, giving more business opportunity or giving more percentage of profit, anything. They have already business ratio proportion. That with that basic business ratio proportion, they will be promoting. So rating is also a vital important. Then complete that customer detail, profile is registered. So how many immediately after that ride, what is the amount you paid? What is the distance you have traveled? Then what is the model of car you preferred? So based on that, it wanted to give further recommendation. So next, the moment drop rating, all the details are recorded. The amount you paid, the distance you traveled, all those things. Beyond that, coming here, before OTP or after the contact, price fixing. This is called dynamic price fixing. If you look at based on the demand, here also this historical data is playing a role. Based on the historical data, they will fix the nominal price. Then based on the demand by that moment, maybe a JNTU nearby, one fine day it will become unusual demand may come. So this is based on demand as well, not only based on historical data, present demand together, it will go for dynamic price fixing. The rate of the ride, every if you try to travel by, when I was at Aziz Nagar, from Aziz Nagar to Secunderabad, different packages I have traveled, more than 20 times I have traveled. Now minimum I am telling, maximum I would have traveled 50 times. But every time the rate would be different. I started having the ride with 280 rupees also, the same distance only, but timing will vary. Sometimes time also the same, that I used to catch up that ride, the same timing I will follow. Sometimes it will go up to 1100 rupees also. Highest I paid between Aziz Nagar to Secunderabad, 1100 also, and 300 also, 290 also I have paid. So how this rate is fixed? Based on the monumental data and the demand by that time, then the availability of car as well, some parameter they will take. Finally, analytics, what exactly they are doing, I don't know. This is their business secret. How I know those all? So these are all the analytics happening. You guys need to think in different perspective, not only looking at the website, not only reading and transmitting the information. You need to think in bigger perspective. You need to consider one scenario, how and all the business can be promoted, what's happening. Dynamic price fixing, when it comes air flight, dynamic price fixing is happening. How the air flight is fixing? Based on the historical or monumental data. In addition, the present demand are already booked, all those things, based on that, every minute the price will vary. Within that also they will have minimum threshold, maximum threshold. Beyond that you can't do the price fixing. That is where stochastic model, all those concepts we will be discussing mostly in the fourth unit. Dynamic price fixing is vital syllabus focus given in your business analytics. That is a good, a trending topic. You should be feeling happy, but it involves with a lot of mathematics. So you need to understand the concept as well as mathematics. Dynamic price fixing is hot cake, not only with the flight and Uber, Ola. Dynamic price fixing is with all the e-commerce business. If you look at the salwar rate, morning it would be different, evening it would be different. So it is based on competitors also, it will fix. Based on competitors, demand, monumental data, what are all other factors they will consider, you and me cannot predict. So they need to increase the profit, they need to optimize, they need to increase the satisfaction of the customer as well. So by the time, because of the costlier affair, if you drop the that particular call, then that also will become influential point. How many drops comes? That is the reason cost need to be changed. Although the algorithm fix more cost, no one is ready to afford, no one is ready to invite that business. Then what they can do with that increasing the price? They need to come down. So that is another case. So depending upon demand and all those things, then it comes here. Forecasting analytics. Picture comes here, forecasting analytics. Forecasting only called prescriptive or predictive analytics. Then beyond that, contacting passenger and driver. After this contact, a call, if the passenger is denying the services, immediately that is also recorded. Why this denial is happening? When it happens, what kind of situation is happening? Denial. Passenger, denial of services also. You will book, you will search for the car and everything you will do. You will talk to the driver as well, but you will deny the ride. Why it is? Then they need to investigate that also. So it goes a lot. Beyond that, every passenger per month, they will put the ceiling. Beyond that, we cannot cancel the ride. Once if we start searching is no problem. After the contact establishment, the moment, yes, I want to ride, then one button will be there. In that app, if you click, I want to ride, then the moment you click the button, what will happen? Then you should not drop. If you are trying to drop, they will analyze, that is their business style. For the passenger, what is the penalty they are giving? They will have maximum denial of services per month this much. After that, it should not go. So that this data also they are getting recording. They are recorded. If it goes beyond that set limitation, then it will be treated in different way. So these are all the way that the entire Uber case goes on. Just imagine, I'm just picking few, four, five scenario of Uber. Within, beyond that, there are a lot many more will be available. Not only what I am telling. This is the way you need to think the complete case I am bringing. So far now, the earlier points, whatever we discussed is with respect to e-commerce, these all. These are all the guys not doing e-commerce. This is a transportation business. So these all complete transportation and freight services. So how it goes there also? If you look at Bharat Matrimony, the way in which they look at the data, analyzes the data, it will be entirely different. You can't behave like this. Customer promotion, how you will do? They're married, unmarried, based on religion, height, preference. The way in which Bharat Matrimony analyzes, it would be entirely different. Naukri, if you look at a lot of data analytics is happening with the Naukri. So the way in which they look at and analyze is different because it is entirely dependent on business domain. Social media analytics, every day, every minute, LinkedIn is analyzing a lot. Facebook is analyzing a lot. How those analytics, WhatsApp is also having a lot of analytics. How those are happening? It all varies. You need to take into one cases and you need to drill a lot. What are all the way business analytics is happening in that business? How do they filter? How do they analyze? How do they move forward? So this is how you need to widen your perspective when you are doing this subject. So with that chatbot, look at this. What are all the way you can analyze? These are all way of analyzing. Chronologically, we are speaking. Past data analysis, present data analysis, future data analysis. Then subject wise, insight or information. Insight is for future. Information is for knowing. What I can do with information, what is happening in and around within the college, within the quarters, what I can do with that information. Say information. Insight is what? I need to predict what will happen. If I look at your past semester result, it is information for me. Nothing I can do out of that. It is gone case, whether you failed also, passed also, or extraordinary performance also, it is mere information for me. Nothing I can do with that. Insight, how can I make your performance better in the forthcoming semester? When I think in that perspective, then it becomes insight. For the insight, that information is helpful. If I have a rough idea, how roll number one is performing, how roll number two is performing, three is performing, if I have a rough idea, what would be the intellectual level of that each candidate? What is the capability of each candidate? What was the learning behavior of every one of you in the last semester? If that information will be helping in order to take decision for the future. So what happened? Reporting. What is happening? Alerts. What will happen? Extrapolation. Anything which you are trying to predict for future in the technical world, it is called extrapolation. So next, how and why did it happen? So how it happened, why did it happen, for these questions answer will be given by modelings and experimental designs. What's the next best action recommendation? Here only recommendation system comes. As you guys mentioned, what whenever you go for Amazon Prime and Netflix, these all those sites, it gives you recommendation. Even Amazon starts a recommendation. The moment I look at one product, immediately it is telling. Always I used to look at kitchen items, and I used to look at groceries and cloths. That is a fashion cloth, that a women cloth wear. I will look at I don't choose for anyone else except myself. So if I look at that, what I am clicking that button also becomes matter. Any product comes, any promotion comes, immediately it gives me pop-ups in my Gmail. If you look at, lot of promotions are given there. So if you look at Gmail itself, working based on analytics, classification. Majorly your email is classified into five categories: inbox, spam, promotion, updates, and social. the moment the website is declared a social media, all the social media connectivity information comes to social. When it comes promotion, any other website, anything it starts promoting with you, that comes in promotion. Then what is the meaning of update? Whichever the website you are registering for, if I am registering for Amazon, I am not registering for Flipkart. And Flipkart comes in promotion. Amazon will comes in updates. So if you are going for any other educational website, if you, they will be asking you to drop the mail blocks. If you visit, they'll be asking you to drop the mailbox, mail ID. The moment you give that mail ID, they'll be start keep on giving all the promotions, all their new articles. If you register for any YouTube channel, any new video comes in, pop-ups will come. If you subscribe YouTube channel, if you subscribe for blogs, it will come. All those things will be segregated to update. So everywhere this analytics is considered. So that is called recommendation. Based on that, it will be giving. Then what is the best or worst can happen? Prediction, optimization, simulation. And not only analytics, we may need to be good at optimization and simulation as well. Because next to the limitation of the data analytics, optimization and simulation only helps you a lot. So this is the other two domain. We need to be versatile all along with the data analytics. Only then you will become, you will be said as expert in data analytics. Not only with the data analytics, if you know 10 model, 15 model, forecasting model, if you know time series analysis, ARIMA model, ARMA model, if you know only the models, 5-10 classification model, 3-4 prediction model, if you know only 15 models, you are not be said as expert. In addition, if you increase the capability of using optimization technique and simulation technique, you will be labeled as expert. Until then, you can be called as beginner or intermediate expertise. So that is where it goes inside. It becomes more powerful. What is the best? For Ola and Uber car price fixing, prediction alone will not be helpful. Air flight, air services price fixing, prediction alone not sufficient. Optimization, simulation techniques also we need to be in the position to apply. Only then those all business will go in smooth manner. Otherwise it will become, see, running business is not so easy. Lot of time filing the case will happen. Lot of time penalty will happen. Court order they need to face. So all those perspectives they need to keep in their mind and they need to do every decision making. So that leaking of the customer's detail is also one of the offense. So what level of security, what level of analytics, what level of privacy policies, what level of that particular country government rules and regulations, policies, all those things they need to consider, then only they need to take business decision. So not merely focusing on I want more profit, more profit. So they need to focus on end dimension, end direction. By the time you need to be in the position to do analytics or compute the decisions based on simulation as well as optimization. Now coming to strategic benefit. Competitive advantage. If you do this all analytics, what is your benefit? Why you need to go for analytics? Competitive advantage, alignment with the customer or with the supply chain, everywhere. Customer relations, informational benefit, information access, information quality, information flexibility. Transactional benefit, communication efficiency, system development efficiency, business efficiency. These are all the kind of benefits we can harvest with the support of business analytics or intelligence. Look at again benefits, faster reporting, analysis or planning, more accurate reporting, analysis or planning, better business decision, improved data quality, improved employee satisfaction, improved customer satisfaction, both are possible. Operational efficiency, so speed, how quick you are doing, how efficient you are doing is called operational efficiency. So increased competitive advantage, reduced cost is also carried out with the help of data analytics, increased revenues or profit, saved hand count. So these are all the merits or benefits of moving with data analytics or business intelligence or business analytics. Coming to here, finally, key takeaways. Competitive advantage is primarily important for our own survival. Simultaneously, it needs to take care of all other optimization, speed of not only competitive advantage. Because of that, all should go in parallel. Speed of processing, speed of delivery, customer satisfaction, employee satisfaction, all the perspectives. See, customer also should satisfy, employee also should satisfy, employer also should feel satisfied. That is where optimization comes. That is where simulation comes. So these are all the points you may need to consider when it comes to competitive advantage of business analytics. Next topic onwards or next class onwards, we'll be moving on to descriptive statistical methods and models. With that, today I'm going to conclude the session.